Hey friends, we are going to do a breaking down the score today from one of my favorite musicals, Sweeney Todd. We're going to look at Wait. Sondheim actually, when he was alive and when he would talk about this song, he said it was probably his least favorite song in the show. I'm probably going to skip a lot of the beginning because it's mostly just the beggar woman. But she does the alms, alms for a miserable. And then there's no woman because then it goes right into thank you, sir, and all these other dialogue things. So we're going to skip right down to the bottom of the first page. Now, you could buy the full score for this somewhere. I think on Hal Leonard's website or one of the other many places you could buy scores. I think it's like $100 or $120 for the paper copy. And you notice we have this theme going on. This is what it sounds like. The epiphany when Sweeney goes completely crazy, having the same exact thematic material, but faster. This is exactly what that is. And it sounds wonky because you have this weird, if I just played a bottom note by itself, doesn't sound too peppy. Now that's a thematic thing that Mrs. Lovett sings later in the song, but I want you to pay attention to this theme because it does change throughout the journey of Wait. And we go on to the next page, and Beggar Woman still sings to that theme being played. Alms, alms for a desperate woman. Then the theme changes a little bit at this 3-4 bar. It's no longer symmetrical. Because we've been hearing 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now it changes. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this theme is everywhere and he shifts it and it's kind of, I consider it like the contemplative theme of Sweeney. Now we get to the bottom of the page and we have bar 22 where it does the theme still. We do rhythmic augmentation, meaning we elongate the rhythms from what it was before. Same theme, but now quarter notes instead of eighth notes. And it just gives you like a haunting feeling before she even sings. So Mrs. Lovett is trying to get Sweeney to kind of calm himself, wait for the judge. Don't be in a hurry, which is kind of an important pinnacle moment because later Sweeney flips out on her and is like, you told me to wait. And I waited. And now he got away. And now it like sets him off. This is why this song's kind of very important at this part of the show. She sings, easy now, hush, love, hush. Don't distress yourself. What's your rush? Now, what's really cool is in the piano or in the orchestra parts, there's this chromatic, which it doesn't always stay chromatic, but it's kind of this rising line that I equate to building suspense. So if you listen to it by itself with the bass notes, it's like, oh my God, we're getting closer and closer and closer. But she's kind of trying to soothe him. Keep your thoughts nice and lush. And then you have these minor seconds and minor ninths all over the place. And then she goes to wait. And then you notice here in the dial, in the stage directions, it says Todd keeps pacing. And you notice that this theme comes back again. Pacing music. And she reassures him and calms him down. Hush, love, hush. Think it through. Once it bubbles, then what's to do? Now, that's a beautiful melodic line here. It's a tritone going from to do. What's to do? It's like only Sondheim is someone that I could think of who could make a tritone sound so beautiful and luscious like that. And she goes on to watch it close, let it brew. And she's singing this beautiful melody on this. Really clashing minor seconds. Then she goes into wait. Todd grows calmer, so it's working. She's calming him. Wait. But now something at 45 changes in this melody that we've been hearing all over the place. Now Mrs. Lovett is trying to distract him, thinking of something else. Now she's singing, I've been thinking flowers, maybe daisies, to brighten up the room. It's a different mood shift. We go from this, like, thinking about killing the judge into flowers and pretty things to brighten up the room. Now, Sondheim is brilliant at this because he takes that whole nasty, ugly theme, and he puts it here in 45, but listen to what it does at 45. It's different. Now we're getting into more triad, more harmonically current sounding. So we have an A flat with the second thrown in there. More pretty, which sets it up and makes it sound more beautiful, which it's text painting what the lyrics are. I've been thinking, and now we get this lush, D flat is such a lush key for me. Flowers, maybe daisies, to brighten up the room. Now, the chords here still follow that similar pattern, but it's more bright and happy and in a more major tonal key than what we've been hearing up to this. Now, what's cool about this melody here on Brighten Up the Room, it's the same thing that Sondheim uses later in the Epiphany when he says, but not for long. He takes it and reweaves it into its own different melody. But this melody comes back a lot throughout the show in different formations. The melody is so important that he repeats it two more times after Mrs. Lovett sings it at this moment. He sings, to brighten up the room. It's really text painting here. Don't you think some flowers, pretty daisies, might relieve the gloom? Now, the tonality changes here, meaning the first time the end of this phrase happened, we were at an A flat chord with a C in the bass. Now we have might relieve the gloom with an F minor, kind of goes with the text. And then Sweeney doesn't respond. Really cool at 54, this left-hand thing going on. It's the same thematic material as the beginning of the show when he's coming in on a boat with Anthony. Same theme as, you know, the prologue. But it's a more steady rhythm, calming rhythm. Wait, love, wait. And there's that theme again, ba-da-ba-da-dum. And then it echoes throughout the orchestra. Then Todd, intensely, and the judge, when will I get him? But you go back to this. Now with accents on those unpleasant, dissonant, open fifths and major seventh chords. Then it goes into three. Goes back into four. And she goes back to reassuring him. Slow love, slow, a time so fast. Now goes quickly, see, now it's past. Soon will come, soon will last. And it goes down the octave now instead of the tritone. But again, you hear the orchestra's building that tension. Sweeney's brooding. All I mean, it's just so crunchy, but it's so cool how he's layered the accompaniment to be very atonal and dissonant along this beautiful ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum. And it really is kind of painting that picture musically for what's happening. He's brooding, he's stewing, he's pissed, he wants to kill the judge. She's like, easy, calm, slow, steady, wait, it'll come. And here, let's look at some flowers. So the music actually is really painting that for us, okay? And then it says here in a stage direction at 74, Todd grows calm again with her singing, wait. And then she goes, don't you know, silly man, half the fun is to plan the plan. All good things come to those who can. Wait. But I think Angela Lansbury actually stays on A flat, so I don't know if that's correct here. Those who can wait. Back to that contemplative thematic thing here with the eighth notes. And then she goes back to the flowers. But now with the crunchy, crunchy notes instead of the pretty, instead of daisies. I don't know, though. What do you think? And now she's waiting for his response with this. And again, now Sondheim changes the pattern here of the rhythm. It's not just eighth notes. Eighth, eighth, quarter, quarter. Then it slows down, quarter. He says, yes, docilely. Gently takes the razor from him. Gillyflowers, I'd say. And then we end in major. Nothing like a nice bowl of gillies. It's just really cool, all these themes. You notice that, like, each note of this is purposefully put there. It's intended to be in those places for a reason. You know, Sondheim doesn't write or didn't write by mistake. You know, there was an intent for every single dot on the page, and how it worked with the stage direction and the acting and the theater. Even though he hated this piece, I think it's really beautiful how it's stitched together. It's got an eeriness to it, but a calmingness as well for Mrs. Lovett to try to soothe him. I hope y'all got a lot from this, and we will talk soon. Bye.